Greetings. It's a pleasure to see you today. I appreciate you. Thank you for your presence and for listening and for being here with me. My name is Sue. This is my channel that I speak about meditation, which I have found is the most important, most major thing in my life. It has had the greatest effect on change and on positive change for me. So I go all over the place, but eventually I get to the point, and I hope I can make you smile and maybe laugh. Maybe not. I don't know. We are together in the eternal now. It is always now. And I was having a rough day a couple of days ago. It was a really intense energy day. And I was speaking with a friend of mine, my 85-year-old beautiful Reiki teacher, and she reminded me of something that was, it's just so beautiful. She reminded me that to bring myself back into the now, into the present moment, you know, just get right back there, because in the present moment, there's no future, there's no past, there's nothing. This is super loud. Oh my gosh. It's okay, I'll get closer. And I did that, you know, I brought myself back into the present moment, and I remember this so vividly. I was like, well, what about what's going to happen next, you know? And then I realized, just stay in the moment, stay in the moment, stay in the moment. And it's super powerful. And if you haven't ever heard of the present moment, the now, the eternal now, I would highly recommend to you to, you know, read up about it. It's everywhere. So today I made Darjeeling tea with honey. This is so good. I would say that about everything. It's not true, but it seems like it. Like, oh, this tea is so good. But that tea is really, really good. Organic Darjeeling tea with honey. Thank you for this tea. And thank you for this time to be with myself and with others. Thank you for channeling through me. Right before I turned the record button on, I did a few ohms, which I've realized are, it hollows you out. It activates the chakras and it hollows you out, so you're like a reed. And it feels amazing too, because you can really feel, when you pay attention, you can feel the sound of your voice, like spinning the chakras, and then it just whoosh, hollows you out, and the sound just moves through you like you're a flute or a reed. Om is the sound of the universe. It's the first sound of creation. It's all that is. It's source. It's it's super fun to do that, and maybe not today, but another day I'll we can do some oming together. It's cool. When I was doing it, it reminded me of the fact that that source is, that when I step out of the way, like when I om and my chakras spin and my body hollows out, there's space, you know, there's space for source to move and to flow. I apologize for the loudness of this music today. It's hella loud, but I don't feel like getting up to turn it off because I'll have to turn off the video. So thank you. All right, so meditation. Today I was meditating and my cat, Mugwort, got into my lap, which was fine, and it made me super conscious of my body and how I was, if I was moving or not moving, and it reminded me of stillness, because I was being as, my body was as still as I could possibly keep it, and when your body is still, you become still, like your mind becomes more still, and your breath becomes more still, and you feel really good. You feel, it's like that's when you can really connect with source, is when you're still. And it's not easy to keep your body still. It is definitely a practice, but when you focus on it and just consider that, oh my gosh, I'm fidgeting, I'm moving, I'm uncomfortable, my neck aches, I need to stretch. I mean, it's like kind of like that. Like, you can be doing that a while to get yourself still, and that's okay. You know, that's one thing I've learned, is at first I was just like, oh, I can't get still. But it's a practice, and it will come over time. And some days, you know, you just get still right away, and some days it takes a good solid 10 minutes to get still. Excuse me, I'm gonna have some tea. The room where you meditate doesn't have to be like perfectly silent. It's really best if there's nobody else in the room, and if there is, if they're meditating too. Today I had to get up toward the end to let Mugwort out, and that happens too. I mean, there's no, you're really not striving for perfection here at all. Like, some days you have to get up, let the cat out, let the cat in, do something, and just get back, just do it, and then go sit back down, and you'll get right back to it. And your muscle has memory, and you'll basically get back to where you were. It's not a thing. It's not a big deal. It happens. Perhaps if you were meditating in an ashram, in a place that's made for meditation and everything's, you know, set up perfect, well, that's another story. And that's, I've been on one meditation retreat. It was a Zen meditation retreat. It was so fantastic. And I just realized that I want to do another one. I want to do another meditation retreat. It really, that meditation retreat, that was before I started meditating every day. And I was just kind of dabbling. But that retreat taught me about stillness and about sitting, even if you're uncomfortable and not moving, because I was in this little hut thing. It was such a cute little house, and there were meditation pillows along each wall, and the teacher, I was sitting right next to the teacher, and he had a timer that was hooked up to a singing bowl. And I have a feeling that we meditated for 30 minutes at a pop, and we meditated probably three times a day. It was over a weekend, and we also had to do chores, which was cool. We did outside work, and we had breaks, and we ate and drank tea. It was really great. I loved it. And what I was trying to say about that is that, like, it was a perfect thing to learn how to sit still for 30 minutes. Because there was a bunch of people around, and if you started like fidgeting, you're gonna bother them. So it's like you're forced because of other people. So I appreciate that reminder. I'd like to do another retreat. We'll see about what happens. We are still gonna be locked down like fucking slaves. I do not consent. I am not a slave. I am a sovereign being. I was born a sovereign being. I went straight into slavery, but now I'm awakening into my sovereignty, into my pure freedom, and into my absolute and total connection with Source. Nothing can harm me when I'm connected with Source. So there's that. I feel very passionate about that subject. I'm not going to go into it here on this channel because I don't want to get shut down. And if I do get shut down, oh well, just start over somewhere else. I'm going to be careful. I'm going to speak about meditation and about things that aren't heated and aren't censored. So. We just came out of the solstice. We just came out of the solar eclipse. It was a full eclipse, not a partial. I saw some pictures of it. It was so cool. So cool. We had a solar eclipse in my part of the world a few years ago, and it was like, it was the coolest thing. I'll never, ever, ever forget it. And I observed it and experienced it on my own, in my own backyard, and I was running everywhere. I was running to the front, running to the back, seeing the light, taking pictures, just like, I put my face to that light. It was so odd. It was so cool. If you've ever been, if you ever had the chance to witness a solar eclipse in person, I highly recommend it. And I've also sat through lunar eclipses too. I remember one year my daughter and I sat outside on lawn chairs and stayed up all night. It was really fun. So it's a really powerful experience. Nature is it, and that's where I'm headed. It's my aim to get outside on the land. No shoes, dirty feet, fire, like fires every night, growing food, planting trees, harvesting. That's my heart is pulling me toward that. That's exciting. I'm very excited for that. And I don't know what part of the world it'll be. It'd be rad if it was in somewhere like, I don't know, that was tropical, that you could grow every month of every year. So, yay! That's exciting. I feel like as a species, we're starting to want to go back to communal living, to be on the land, to share everything, you know, share abundance, share chores, share music and dancing and laughter and happiness and joy, being outside and being on Gaia. I feel like we're really headed in that direction. That's where I'm headed, and I'm so excited to meet people who are also headed in that direction. It's really, really fun, really exciting. So I welcome you to leave me comments if you want to share with me what your meditation story is, what you've experienced, how you meditate, if you have questions about it. I'm not a professional meditator. I just meditate every day for 20 minutes or 21 or 22 minutes. And it is, it's great. I'm getting ready to gush here about meditation, but it's life-altering. It puts you onto a joyful track, onto a joyful road to experience life in a joyful way. Not like I'm just like, woo-hoo, all the time. It's not like that. But inside, like, it just feels like there's a warm fire burning all the time now. Even if I'm funky, even if I'm going through stuff, even if painful emotions are coming up, you know, or feeling just like anxiety, that still comes up. It still happens. It's not like you're never going to feel another emotion. And on that subject, that is why what we are, that's what we humans do. A lot of other, you know, beings in the galaxy don't. And we do, and we're masters at it. And what's so amazing about meditation is that once you start, you become the master of your emotions. You get to have them, and you can experience them and be in them when they're happening, you know, like, just experience it, feel it, feel it where it is in your body. Go to that place in your body and breathe into it, you know. It's like we can be in the moment with our emotions, have them, feel them, experience them, and then breathe into them and let them go out and dissipate, you know. We don't have to hold on to them and bury them, even though if that we're taught to do that. We're taught from our families and from society and from sitcoms and all that kind of stuff to pretend like everything's just perfect, you know, like everything's perfect. I never have bad feelings, but then erupt into anger or moody, broody silences or, you know, all that kind of stuff. Like when you take responsibility, 100% responsibility for you and your life and your emotions, then guess what? Let's say you're with your partner or with a friend or with someone you don't know very well and you are triggered. And so your inclination would be to just like pretend like you weren't triggered and like you're not feeling anything. But what's possible is that you can say, oh, wow, I'm feeling this feeling. Give me a second here. You know, like acknowledge it. It's not anything to be ashamed of. It's our right. It's our gift. It's our greatest gift. So feelings are okay. You don't have to, like, you don't have to copy the people around you, like your parents or your ancestors or your friends or TV. You don't have to, you know, stuff them down and then explode, or you don't have to just get super angry and take out all of your unprocessed emotions on people, or, you know, you don't have to take anything personally. It's not personal. So I appreciate you, and I want to thank you for your presence, for listening. If you feel like it, you can like this video, you can share it with your friends, you can subscribe to my channel if you want. I'm just, you know, I'm new at this, and I'm probably breaking all the rules, which, oh well. It's okay. All I need to do is speak what's in my heart and what I'm sort of being told to do, what I'm being asked to do, what I'm being guided to do. Speak about meditation. Speak about sitting still for 20 minutes with your eyes closed, your spine straight. I wanted to also mention that when I'm sitting in meditation and my eyes are closed, I bring my attention to my third eye space, just up that point between your brows, above your brows. With closed eyes, I look up there, kind of like with your mind's eye, but also with my actual eyes. And what you'll find is when you do that, eventually you start to see light there. And it's really amazing when you actually get the sense of that light. Our pineal glands, our third eyes, are lit. And there are many things that keep them dimmed, like fluoride is one of the things. Chemicals is another thing. Chemicals in food, chemicals in the air. But it's really easy to give up fluoride toothpaste and give up chemical foods. But also your mind is very powerful, so you can, you know, envision your third eye being all that stuff being sort of chiseled off and scraped off so that it can shine as bright as any star. Anyway, I thought I'd mention that today because that's where I focus in my mind. I just focus up at my third eye. And that light, you know, it's so bright that it, like, you can feel it just going up through your crown and opening the crown chakra. I read that somewhere, I think on Twitter maybe yesterday, someone said that about when you focus on your third eye, it opens your crown when you're meditating. And that's what I've been doing for a long time, and it certainly does happen. And also that light from your third eye is so bright that it activates, you know, your throat and your heart. You can feel it go all the way down into your heart. So it's something to try. We're almost to the 21st. It's the 15th. We have 6 days till the winter solstice or the summer solstice, wherever you're living. But the 21st of December 2020, the great awakening. I'm excited. I've been hearing people say that don't think it's going to be like a big, like solar flash or whatever. Some people are saying it's going to be a flash inside of humanity's consciousness. I think things are really going to really shift. Things have shifted so much already, but I feel like this date, we've already seen so much in the awakening of humanity and the throwing off our shackles. So pay attention, watch what's going on, feel what's going on inside of yourself, meditate every day. Even if you start today, by the 21st, you're going to be in a different zone. I wish you so much love. I wish you so much joy. I send you love and joy and an absolute deep happiness. You are loved. You are adored. You have great worth and value, and you shine like the sun. And I love you. Peace.